Hello everybody, welcome to Squire's Ladies Refit Part 5. In this episode we're going to talk about some of the work that we've done over the past 3 months, which is sanding, scraping, filling and painting the boat sides. As you've seen on a previous video, that we were really proud to get our first layer of paint on Squire's Lady, even though it was just on the keel. Back in April, May time, you can see from these photos that all the antifouls still on the boat. So for the full weekend, we spent our time under the boat scraping away. We had a little bit of moisture in the hull. So what we did is we sorted that out by cutting small holes in with a Dremel, drying it out and then filling it in with some epoxy filler. As I mentioned in a previous video, the paint off the sides of the boat was a proper pain to get off. We tried marine filler, sanding it, and then we decided we were going to go for the heat gun option. Being really careful that we didn't ruin the boat side, I reckon we were probably getting about a square metre off every 2 to 3 hours. The paint we ordered came, so we were a little bit excited to get a coat on, so we decided to do under the waterline. Jen carried on with the heat gun getting the rest of the paint off, and while she was doing that I started sanding down and then using some underwater filler to get a flat finish. Once the whole boat was painted, we could see there was an awful lot of imperfections, bumps and small dips. So using a fine filler, we decided to fill these bumps and dips in, then using a long board, sanding it down. Once it was fully sanded, we decided to give it another coat of paint, and then we started the process again, and we've done that 5 more times. Next weekend when I'm down a boat, if the weather's dry, we'll end up top lacking above the waterline, but below the waterline we'll save that till just before we go underwater. I've got some underwater primer and then some antifoul. Thank you.
as you've seen by the previous videos, that Squire's Lady needs a new engine. I'm a little bit unsure on what to get. One of the main factors in this is cost. So some of the options is an inboard diesel engine, an outboard petrol engine, or possibly an inboard electric engine. If you have any thoughts or comments on that, leave them below and possibly give me some pros and cons. Thanks for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. See you next week, everybody.